Welcome, everyone, to the final game of the college basketball season. Tonight, we will crown the winner of this year's tournament. And no matter what the outcome here tonight, what a ride it has been. Along with Greg Anthony and Clark Kellogg, this is Kevin Harlan. We'll see the Wisconsin Badgers and the Michigan Wolverines.
You got that right. I mean, this is what each student athlete has worked so hard for all season long. An opportunity for the Titans. I mean, this game might very well be the defining moment for the lives of every one of these young men.
Both these teams have gone through so much adversity just to make it here. All tournament long, it's been survive and advance. But now, this is the part where you put all your chips on the table and just lay it on the line.
And Wisconsin, looking at who they've got. Hill is out there with Hawkins. Then it's Kaminsky, then it's Decker, and it's Evans in at the four slot.
And with any championship game, you know that every player is going to have their heart racing for the first few minutes. That's just natural. That's adrenaline. They'll need to remain calm, though, and let the game come to them and kind of ease into it.
And one guy, guys, I'll keep an eye on. And this one is freak. He is the consummate leader for his team. He can come out strong and play his game while keeping his intensity level up. It'll be just what they need to claim the title.
Here's Hill. The Wolverines making their last shot. Decker with it, working on Jones. Fades and shoots, and the basket by Kaminsky.
Yeah, it's just a smart shot taking advantage of the mismatch.
Well, with a stroke like that and the height advantage as well, the mid-range J is almost a gimme. You know, Wisconsin has not historically had a lot of players in the NBA. That number, however, could be growing in the next few seasons. I mean, they have a few, but for the most part, their winning has come through solid team play.
And what a journey it has been, really, for this whole team to make it to the college championship, especially for Freak. A few bumps in the road for him, but what a story.
Greg, you get the feeling that it's only the beginning. I mean, the way he plays and the accolades he has, I mean, you can see him having a long and productive career at the pro level.
That's good. Hill's got his first 2 points of the night. Greg, I think you were talking about this just a moment ago. We'll be seeing more and more Badgers in the NBA with their recent success, Frank Kaminsky being the most recent NBA product.
And Kaminsky isn't alone. Sam Decker on that squad will be coming in. How about John Luhr and Greg Stiesma and Devin Harris, our all fellow Wisconsin alums. You look at the list and you see a lot of guys who know how to do the little things for a team.
Here is Hawkins following the basket by Freak. No good from Wade.
And as we see Freak and his team go for the title here, he is trying to repeat what he did just a year ago. He was able to lead his high school to the PSAL championship.
Well, Greg, he was a four-time All-American selection in high school and a unanimous one at that. He's won state titles before, but this is a different animal than high school.
Michigan ends up going with a new group, and Wisconsin going with almost an entirely new group here. And Wisconsin looking at who they've got. They've got Fisher. He's out there with Hill. Decker is out there with Kaminsky. And it's Evans in at the four spot. Here's Fisher. Out left to the wing. A shot by Kaminsky. Nobody around. No good on the three. Here's Flash. The drive by Green takes it into the teeth to the D and converts the layup. Green's got 9.
Hard to get that one off with the size difference there. That makes it a tough individual matchup for him, especially down low.
Well, took on the big guys going in there and challenging them like he did. But, boy, that was a nice job.
And again, it's the Badgers missing.
The defense there got away with a major lapse.
You know, one of the big questions on everybody's mind in this game is whether or not Freak will stay on for another year or go pro. I mean, usually a player with his upside will be a lock to be a one and done, but he's giving serious thought to staying.
And Freak is a guy who clearly values the scholastic aspect of collegiate sports, so it makes sense for him to think about staying beyond this season. Still, with Freak's draft stock rising, this could be his final game as a collegiate player.
Here we go, one-on-one, and he makes no mistake on the slam dunk.
Rising high to throw that one down.
Sky high, fantastic one-hand jam.
Nice way there, guys, to finish up that possession.
Fisher against Green. There's a screen. Here's Payton. Can't get it to go. Now the Wolverines take it the other way. And it's Green missing.
There was just enough defensive pressure to get him off balance and cause that shot to go awry.
And they double up Payton. Over to the wing. And Walker kicks to Payton. Feeds it to Fisher. Takes a three. And it's Michigan with the rebound. Smith's got three rebounds now in this one. And Green slams it in.
Punches it down with pop.
Rubs it in. It looks like a little deeper with the hanging finish.
I tell you what, they're not backing off at all, are they?
It's 9 seconds separating the shot clock and game clock. Payton kicks to Fisher. Now the pass to Decker. Shot clock at 6. That one wide left. Puts it up from 17. And Green with the basket on the assist by Smith. 17 points for Freak.
I like the recognition of the mismatch there, immediately making the defense pay.
And the first half is now in the books. Michigan leads by 8. We'll see you after halftime for the beginning of the second half. Just one half of basketball left to determine. And the big game is just about ready to get going for our second half of play. What a championship atmosphere we've got here tonight. We are just one half of basketball away from seeing college basketball history being made.
You know what, guys? That was the start that Freak and his team wanted in the first half. I mean, they didn't run away with the game, but they're in a really good spot to capture the title.
These first 5 minutes in the second half are going to be huge. They know their opponent is going to come out strong and try to even things up. But if they can keep their cool, they'll be on their way, I think, to the title.
Green in at shooting guard. Smith is out there with Ellis. Then there's Flash, and it's Jones in at the three slot. And for the Badgers, they've got Hill. He's out there with Hawkins. Kaminsky out there with Decker. And it's Evans in at the four-man position.
Perfect screen there. Set him up with a terrific look.
Yeah, I like the fact that the setup was good, the screen was solid, but you also have to look at the fact the defender didn't do his job as well as he could have.
And guys, one big story that we have in this championship game is that a guy like Freak could boost his draft stock quite a bit. A win here could catapult him up the big boards of a lot of teams.
And you know, while it's just one game, scouts will get a chance to see how he plays on the big stage. Knowing a player is at his best when the lights are brightest is a big plus in GM's books.
So it's both teams making sense. Now Hawkins. They set the pick. Here's Decker. Green with the rebound.
Just a solid performance on the interior. The rebounding has been off the charts.
Yeah, you look across the board, it's actually sizing up, shaping up to be a great game. I mean, strong performances throughout, and they've really been strong on the glass.
Green, he's in at shooting guard. Ellis is out there with Jones. Then it's Smith. Then it's Flash in at the one spot. Walker's shot is off. Well, Clark, they can burn some clock if they want to.
Yeah, and maybe buy a little oxygen while they're doing it.
And here is Payton. Kaminsky with the ball.
Now Smith defending. Hawkins passes to Walker. And a foul on the shot. He'll go to the stripe for two. And what do you guys think so far about the offensive approach for the Wolverines?
You know, I thought maybe they'd cool off a bit at halftime, but they've continued to bury the jump shot.
Another thing they've done tonight well is share the ball. So many of their points have come off of good, crisp passes.
Here's what Wisconsin's going with right now. Wade, he's checked in for Kaminsky, for Decker, and it's Hill in for Payton.
And with this lead, it looks like they'll hold on for the title. A special moment for everyone on the team. And really, what a year it's been for their star, Freak.
Yeah, very impressive considering everybody pinned their hopes on him to lead the team at the start of the season. And he hasn't disappointed. For all the hype that surrounded him, he lived up to all of it.
Hawkins with it. Evans outside. And it's good. Fought through contact. It's the shot. He'll go to the free throw line.
How about how he sets his man up there, runs him right into the screen, and then gets the basket.
The Badgers making a switch here. Conley's checked in. Here's Green. The Badgers pull it in.
Boy, did they need that rebound. I mean, they have struggled on the boards overall, but still with the chance to win.
Exactly, because they've made enough plays to keep it close. And as a result, they're still in it.
And that's Evans penetrating. Pass to Hawkins. The three from Hill. Can't get it to go. Now the Wolverines take it the other way.
And now as the clock ticks down, this is going to end up as a solid victory here for the Wolverines.
You know, it's tough to put your finger on the deciding factor in this one, but I'd say that the shooting accuracy made the difference.
Shot quality and better overall shooting.
And beyond the actual result of this game, fans are going to look back and see this was just a monstrous performance for Green. There wasn't much they could do to slow him down as he was converting every good chance he got.
So both teams changing it up here. The free throw drops for Green. Here's Fisher. To the middle. Here's Wade. That's good. And the assist goes to Fisher.
Great job to hit his teammate on that move, Kevin.
And Clark, they're this close to putting it away.
Yeah, and they don't need to do anything to reinvent the wheel here. I mean, just take time off the clock and squeeze the orange. Don't turn it over.
Now the dish to Gibson. Inside. It's stolen by Jefferson. Here's Stevenson, banked in off the glass. Stevenson's got the lead up to 14 now for the Wolverines.
You know, huge height advantage there, but because of the great body control, he's able to cancel it out.
Agreed. The body control essential in that situation. I mean, if you're giving up a bunch of height, then you better be able to manufacture things in the air.
I mean, that's a tough break for the D. I mean, he took the hit and drew the whistle.
Yeah, but he was late to get there, Greg, so the referee couldn't give him.
And so it's Michigan winning this one. Such a special moment for these kids. All the hard...
Good evening and welcome to the NBA Draft. With the first pick in the NBA Draft, the Minnesota Timberwolves select Karl Anthony Towns from the University of Kentucky. With the second pick in the NBA draft, the Los Angeles Lakers select D'Angelo Russell from The Ohio State University. With the third pick in the NBA draft, the Philadelphia 76ers select
Jahlil Okafor from Duke University.
With the fourth pick in the NBA draft, the New York Knicks select
Kristaps Porzingis
from Latvia.
With the fifth pick in the NBA draft, the Orlando Magic select
Mario Hezonja from Dubrovnik, Croatia.
With the sixth pick in the NBA draft, the Sacramento Kings select
Willie Cauley-Stein from the University of Kentucky.
With the seventh pick in the NBA draft, the Denver Nuggets select
Emmanuel Mudiay.
With the eighth pick in the NBA draft, the Detroit Pistons select the 19-year-old shooting guard from the University of Michigan.
Towards the darkness.
Nah, yo, look towards the light.
Yo, what the?